The following podcast by Tom Mabe contains hilarious content. You should not drive or operate heavy machinery while listening.
Getting revenge is sweet. They've been calling him at home. Revenge is sweet. Selling something he don't want to own. Revenge is sweet. Now he's messing with their minds. Tom Mabe's gonna show them.
Yeah, there you are, Tom Mabe, coming to you live from Louisville, Kentucky, podcasting capital of the world. So you guys heard me talk about my kid. Yeah, my kid, God gave him lots of energy. I got an email from his school teacher saying, you know, Josh really gets very excitable during lunch hour, or not, they got like 20 minutes, but during lunchtime. And question, what kind of medicine is he on? And is anything changed at home? He's very hyper. So I took, he has juice boxes. And so I just put regular apple juice and sent it to him today at lunch. But I put the apple juice in 5-hour energy drink bottles. Yeah, and I say, buddy, we're out of juice boxes. But Daddy put some apple juice in these little containers here. Don't worry, yes, 5-hour energy drink, but that's not it. It's just apple juice. So I can just see him chugging that during I should take like M&Ms and Skittles and put them in medicine bottles instead of just drinking them out of the bottle. So this is my 10th. Podcast, and you guys have been so great, and everybody's going to my Facebook fan page and liking it, and that's cool. It's facebook.com/TomMabeComedy. You can send us your questions and whatnot. I still get a lot of emails from my regular email is just tom@tommabe.com. And today we are going to, in a little bit, feature this call. This is my third home. This call was recorded in my first home in my 20s. And and I drove a Model A Ford at the time. But this is a call that I had some work done at a Sears service center. And I got someone doing a survey asking me how was the service from the Sears Service Center. So let's take a second here and listen to a call. What's the name of this call? It is called, it's a great call too. One of my favorite calls. I say that about all my calls. If it's not a great call, it doesn't show up on an album or on a podcast. Hey, speaking of podcasts, man, stay tuned because I'm going to do a new video podcast where I can show some of my video. The video podcast is called Tom Mabe Fitness Pranks and Small Engine Repair. And I'm going to cover fitness, some video pranks, and I give tips on like small Briggs & Stratton lawnmower 3.5 horsepower engines. So it's going to be really a diverse podcast. So stay tuned for that. And but here you go. So this is called Too Friendly. This call has to be at least 10 years old. Check it out.
Hi, my name is Carol, and I'm calling to follow up on your recent battery service that you had completed at the Louisville Auto Center the first of the month.
Yeah.
Are you the person that took the vehicle?
Yes, I am.
May I ask you a few follow-up questions on the service that you received?
Yeah, wish you would, please.
I beg your pardon?
Yes, please.
Oh, thank you. For quality insurance, this call may be recorded. There are 7 questions. I'd like you to rate them on a scale from 1 to 4.
Okay.
1, being extremely satisfied. 2, somewhat satisfied. 3, somewhat dissatisfied. And 4, extremely dissatisfied.
I was dissatisfied.
Okay. 1 is the best and 4 is the worst. Okay, the first question. Okay, when we...
The guy made a pass at me at the store, and he made me feel funny. He was a... He's about 6'2", baby blue eyes, and he thought I was gay, and I'm not gay, I don't think. And he was told me that he could get the battery for free for me if I would do things for him. And I'm still upset about that. I haven't been the same, but go ahead. You can ask the second question.
Okay. Well, that's the first question. How would you rate the friendly and courteous attitude of your salesperson? That's a 4. He was too friendly.
He was too friendly, ma'am.
Okay. I'm going to write that down. Okay. Okay. How would you rate the prompt attention of your salesperson?
The what of the salesperson?
Did the salesperson wait on you right away?
Oh, yeah. He wanted me.
Okay.
Oh, God. There was a line. There was 22 people in the line. He said, you come over here. You just come over here. I'll take care of you.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, how would you rate the knowledge and assistance provided by your salesperson? Was knowledgeable and assisted you?
I don't know, because he didn't talk nothing about it except for me and maybe going to the bathroom with him.
Okay, let me put a zero on that.
Mm-hmm.
How would you rate the amount of time it takes to complete the work?
Oh, it took almost 3 hours.
Oh, so you wasn't satisfied with that?
No, he kept me around. He kept on wanting to flirt.
Oh, okay.
So they didn't even bring my truck in.
Okay, how would you rate the quality of work performed?
I guess it's fine. I don't...
Okay. Yeah. Based on everything that you told me, on your overall experience, would you recommend to auto center to your friends, yes or no?
Oh, yes, because most of my friends are gay.
Oh, okay.
So they would like it.
Okay, here's our last question. On a 5-point mm-hmm. scale, overall, how satisfied were you with the service you received just Was you extremely satisfied, very satisfied, 2, 3, dissatisfied, 4, somewhat dissatisfied, 5, extremely dissatisfied?
Can you repeat that one, please?
Okay. Were you, on overall, how satisfied were you based on everything that you told me?
Oh, 5, dissatisfied.
Okay, so that made you very uncomfortable.
Yeah, I'm just using the bathroom. Go ahead, you're fine.
Okay. I'm finished. Thank you for your time.
Oh God, that burns. It burns when I pee now. I wonder, can I make a legal complaint to him? I mean, what can I do about this? What do I do now?
Okay. Why don't you get in touch with the manager?
He was the manager.
That was the manager of the auto department.
Mm-hmm.
What about the manager of the whole store?
Oh, boy. I'm thinking about a lawsuit.
Yeah.
I'm just shaking. I am just crazy, shaking. I'm out of there. You know what I mean? Have you ever had a woman come on to you or anything and make you feel funny like that? It's very uncomfortable.
Yeah, I can imagine.
Oh, golly. I can't even drive by that mall, and I think I'm going to go ahead and sue them and see if I can get reimbursed for that battery. So what do we do now?
Okay. Thank you for your time.
Okay.
I'm so sorry.
Okay. Is there anything else I can do to help you?
Oh, that's all. Thank you for your time.
You leaving now?
Yeah, this is it now.
Oh, okay. Is this finished now?
Oh, we finished.
Oh.
All right. Bye now.
Bye.
Oh, I can't even drive by that mall, and I think about a lawsuit. You know what? No matter, you know, I do pranks all the time, and I will listen to stuff and go, how did I have the nads to do that? I guess, people ask this all, how do you keep from laughing? Well, me personally, I'd be embarrassed if I get out to do something like that, but when I become a character, the character doesn't care. So I really get this method acting thing going where I become this dude who has no clue of any social rule whatsoever, and he has no problem breaking any social rule. And you know what? They're calling from, you know, miles away, maybe even a different state. They're on the phone. I can't see them. Now, the video thing, that's a little different. But I hear that, and sometimes I listen to stuff, and I'll start to cringe. Oh, I'm uncomfortable listening to some of these calls because I think I got social issues that are beyond my control. Anyway, let's take time right now to recognize our sponsor. Gamefly.com. Gamefly has over 7,000 titles to choose from for all game systems and handhelds. No late fees, free shipping, cancel anytime. Come on, doesn't get any better than that. Visit gamefly.com/haha for a free 15-day trial. And seriously, these guys have been generous enough to let me do what I do so you can listen to free content and free calls. So do me a favor, gamefly.com. Just go to gamefly.com/haha for a free 15-day trial. So let's go to a question from the email banks. Dear Tom, I love you. You're probably the most handsome man, most creative, talented, best prankster in the universe. And I mentioned you were handsome, you're creative, you're good looking. And I was wondering if I didn't get an email this week. I'm not going to lie to you. No one emailed me. I sat around waiting for someone to send me an email. I can read it on my podcast. So yeah, I don't have an email. So, but I tell you what, I'm going to wrap up this podcast because I'm very excited about doing the video podcast because I just ordered a green screen and some lawnmower parts and some fitness equipment. And I'm very excited about you guys seeing that. I don't know what the name is going to be. It may be American Mabe or it may just be Tom Mabe Fitness Pranks and Small Engine Repair. So we'll see. But let me wrap up. This is, you know, I have a lot of calls are like 6-7 minutes. This is probably by far the shortest call I've ever done where I was getting revenge on a telemarketer. So here you go.
Hello.
May I speak to the lady of the house, please?
This is she. Hello.
There you go, guys. Tom Mabe podcast number 10. Prank it up. Thanks so much for listening. And please shoot me your emails and all that good stuff. Look me up on Skype. You can leave me a message. I will answer all your questions on the podcast. So TomMabe.com, GameFly.com, and we'll see you next time.
Getting revenge is sweet. They've been calling him at home. Revenge is sweet. Selling something he don't want to own. Revenge is sweet. Now he's messing with their minds. Tom Mabe is gonna show them.
Got one for you, sir.
Oh, what's that?
How many telemarketers does it take to kick your ass?